Welcome. My name is Nick Lologus and I'm an infertility specialist. I've been practicing medicine for 45 years and most of those years have been devoted to helping infertile couples realise their dream. Unfortunately, not everybody can achieve a pregnancy. You might be sitting at home with your husband and you say, let's have a baby, and you'll start trying and it may not happen. And this occurs in 1 in 6 couples. 15% of the population can't achieve a pregnancy. You go off to the doctor, the GP or the specialist, and they will help you. But before you do that, just examine your life. Are you happy? Are you in the right mental frame of mind? Lots of my patients come back from a holiday and they conceive. Some patients come to see me once and they leave and they get pregnant the next month because there are positive vibes surrounding all those things: holidaying, seeing a doctor, having good friends, not in a stressful job, having those things around you that make you happy, that give out these positive particles in your body that will enable you to conceive. So if your mind is right and you're happy, that's fantastic. But let's look at other things. The first one would be lifestyle. So if you're overweight, that's going to impact on your fertility. If you smoke heavily, if you drink heavily, and if you eat a lot of junk food, all those issues will impact on the quality of your sperm and egg. So I'm going to refer to the male sperm as milk, and I'm going to refer to the egg as egg. And the oven is the uterus and the fallopian tube. Because this is an important concept to have, because when you're trying to achieve a pregnancy, it's all about the produce and the oven. And so when you go to see a doctor after you've explored all those issues that I've just discussed to get your mind right, to get your weight right, for example, or to reduce your alcohol, the doctor is going to ask you a few simple questions and do some simple examinations. The first one is, are you having a regular period? That usually means that you're releasing an egg. Are you having frequent intercourse? Once every 3 days or twice a week is adequate. Are you having intercourse at the right time? Is your husband actually ejaculating or releasing his sperm into the vagina? So these are the questions that will be asked, and the doctor will usually know from that conversation if there is a problem. And he'll order some basic investigations, and this will be a semen analysis, the milk. Is the milk thick milk or skinny milk? In other words, is your sperm count good or is it low? Is your wife or partner ovulating? And there are blood tests that can determine this. And is the oven okay? Are the tubes open that allow the meeting of the egg and the milk or the sperm? So these investigations, especially the latter, involve tests to check whether the tube is open. There are three tests that can be organised. One is an ultrasound, where they pass fluid through the uterus and along the tubes. One is an X-ray, again, dye is passed through the uterus and the tubes. And then a surgical procedure called a laparoscopy, which can determine whether the tubes are open, the latter being the much more invasive. But the basic physiology of achieving a pregnancy is this. You have intercourse and your husband, partner, deposits sperm in the vagina at 135 miles an hour. Isn't that fantastic? And the sperm shoots up into the uterus and the sperm make their way into the fallopian tube. They have to reach the egg, which is in the outer third of the tube, sitting there like the Death Star in Star Wars, waiting for Sky Luke Walker to come and fertilize the egg. And once the sperm gets to the egg, it is moved by the little finger processes in the tube, along the tube into the uterus where it implants. And that takes about 5 days. And for 85% of the population, this will occur within 12 months of trying for a pregnancy. But alas, in 15%, it doesn't happen. And our investigations will determine the reason for this. Maybe the tubes are blocked. Maybe the sperm count is very low. Maybe the patient isn't ovulating or releasing eggs. So we have therapies for all those situations. There's always a solution. We can pop the eggs out using tablets or injections. So you've tried, you've been to the doctor, and he tells you that you need help to achieve a pregnancy. Help is there. There's no doubt about that. There are plenty of doctors who have the expertise and the experience, but will they manage you appropriately? And that's the key issue. You want precise information about where you're heading. You want the journey to give you maximum rewards quickly. And so that's very important to get the right advice. Obviously, if you have blocked tubes, you will need to do IVF. If your husband's sperm count is very low, IVF is the answer to your problems. And so this information will be given to you. It's a journey. You may decide, well, I don't want to do that, doctor. I don't want to do IVF. Well, he may give you other treatments which aren't as effective, but this is the journey you're on. And eventually, you'll come to the decision to proceed down the pathway that'll give you the best results. That's our job, to help you make those decisions that are going to achieve a family, a baby for you. That's what we're about.